this game, aka Old Lot, but now Benji. See what he can do. Both comps are locked in. Now, we're definitely getting a bit of flavor.
All Rage, Sin Zhao's level 2, double buffed up. Now gonna be wrapping around on this gank. They're gonna go for this.
And you have vision of what just happened to Potluck.
Oh!
Oh no! They're gonna turn around on stun too, but he gets the shield over to Levi. They're going down, and Levi just put himself in the frying pan! Don't think he's gonna lose double buffs here. Sheep could get himself back in for a silence and a few extra damage bits from Benji. Oh boy. We see a lot of teams just overpowering this bottom lane here. Continuously going in. Even Levi is there. They feel like they can get the drowsy. That's follow-up damage. That's going to be enough to go in for Potluck. He just goes down immediately. What were these guys thinking? As there was obviously...
You saw that objective power man coming in. Sleepy Dragon. That Golden Guardians has started up.
Ooh! What a read!
Someone saw what happened last game, maybe, and was like, let's not be that.
Oh! Putting it to work!
Yeah, right away!
Use in this fight. 100 Thieves watching their positioning as the teleport now comes in. Nice flawless.
Health damage burn. Play for Rikara.
Stunt goes in. Rikara as well. Disarmed on the backside, but nobody's going to really be running through that one. Bob Chin ignites. He's going to stay alive. Potluck is low. Brandini's starting to get cut down now.
It's going down so fast.
Couldn't even tell what that was. It's like, it's a green Drake. What color is green? He's on fire. Potluck goes in as well as Stun. He's trying to get himself to safety now. Everybody piles into the pit, but Golden Guardians have already left. Does that give them the upper hand to now choose which targets they want? As they can see 100 Thieves siphoning out, figuring out which way to go. Benji now in a fight with Brandini.
Or with the flank.
Yeah, see what's going to happen here. He is slowly waiting. They haven't stepped through one, did. Oh, there goes Stun right to the back line of the fight, deleting both Sheep and Potluck as they get their hands in the pie. Who is next here? Zig can't even use his ultimate to be the front line here.
A great flank by Rikara. Oh, we see they're actually going to contest this Baron buff.
The drowsy bubble would really be the thing to hit. That kind of sorts makes you go at all sorts. You have to get a teammate to stand in front of you. That doesn't work. Somebody's standing over there. This guy exits stage left, and they are losing teammates all the same. Good damage from Benji here as he starts off a bit of a fight onto Brandini, who's just keeping himself K with oranges, and not a problem there. 100 Thieves slowly coming back and then taking the lead even slower throughout this game.
Whoa!
What they need. Okay. Benji going in with the ultimate. Beautiful job by 100 Thieves to separate the passive so it doesn't do continuously more damage. And we're back to Baron.
Well, what's interesting is maybe he bought his team enough time with that. You saw they had to go off the Baron and completely region up the fold. Their team doesn't do this.
Sanity's got to be careful. That shield, he's going to go down to 9 kills to a 4-2-5 stunt. He's 9 participation. 100%, I should say, in all 9 of those, rather. Super good job from him, and it just shows you how mobile this map and game is really becoming throughout this meta. Drowsy bubble back, Golden Guardians looking for time number 2. Rikara in the same spot. Deja vu, are we running a replay? Throws out the ultimate, Sheep gets locked up, and again, stunt goes in. Rikara picks up Sheep. Potluck stays alive this time. That's the change they needed, and they turn it back onto Rikara with his flash going down as well. Levi taking big damage down to half health, but that's the front end burst. Where's the follow-up coming in from Golden Guardians? It might be enough time for one. But they want to figure out where the pressure's coming from first. They've lost where Rikara is unless they can get a ward over the wall. Bot lane getting pressure just a little bit, as you saw from the minions as they go in. And Stun wants to get to Rikara for safety, so he uses the team to teleport himself through with the dodges, dips, and dies. They are going to start dropping Golden Guardians left and right. Zig on the back line trying to keep their attention, and the kills for himself as he only grabs Insanity. But the rest of 100 Thieves stands tall, and they take the fight to themselves.
Well, interestingly, Zig's going to be able to heal up here, and Benji's still healthy, so they might still be
able
to.
We saw this before.
Yeah, they might be able to stop this by themselves. Ooh, Zig is getting beat up by Brandini.
Big pillar of flame. Oh, right in front of Baron. That's big damage onto Rikara. Nice dodge by Bendy. The follow-up is going to be huge. As much ground as he can.
And that time, with the death of Benji.
Wow.
Zig not being able to do enough. They're actually going to be able to grab this Baron buff. And Rikara,
Forest Dragon, Golden Guardians gets this, and they might become a problem. Whoa! A very drowsy Rikara goes through, but he wakes up quick, and he starts just doing huge damage to the entire team of Golden Guardians. as they dip left and right. Ziggs is following Levi, pushes Stunt out of the fight. Levi possibly going down here. Oh, if Zig would have hit Elder Drake, he could have finalized the fight there. But he is now going down into 2v1. We saw this happening with Piecake Lord last game, and now Brandini may have to help on the bot side. So much explosive front end damage in the beginning of these fights. Just dropping Golden Guardians members, and you see it leaves Zig by himself. They need to be able to stick together more.
And the team just decided to ignore him, use this Baron buff to push.
Yeah.
Benji actually had a monstrous ultimate that almost won that fight for his team, but Zig was just not in a position to actually get any of the kills. Very tough for Dr. Mundo, just kind of chasing people around. Now he's the one getting chased, Brandini just trying to stop Zig's recall. Not sure he'll ever be able to kill him, but hey, Levi's regened up with the Ocean Drake and Red buff.
God, Zig's not even looking where he's going. He's on the phone. Put the phone down. Oh, man. Oh, he goes down. Nice try. Attempt. Great run, though. Always love a good game of Ring Around the Rosie. You can buy some time, and he's hoping to get Golden Guardians enough time to get back on the map here and stop this Elder Drake. I don't know if it's going to be enough unless a beautiful Star Call comes down from Sheep, and he steals it 10 seconds ago.
Not going to be the case. Fine. Allowing Hunter Thieves to look like they're about in position to close this game out.
Ha! Wow, going full on to Zig here. Rikar not really having the Grievous Wounds for himself, and he sees what kind of impact that actually has.
Uh-oh.
And now Brandini not find himself in a good spot. Three Talon Strike actually hits as Brandini got the flash away, so it kept him in range slightly. Cannot get the parlay back. Pollock very low. Convergence is on him, but it's not going to do extra damage in the Firestorm. Zig doesn't have that ultimate. And he is a glutton for punishment on that Mundo. Goes back in for the fight, but he goes down. Our longest game of the Academy split so far is going to be around 40 minutes here as 100 Thieves come back from their loss yesterday to take a victory.